scripture reading this morning will be coming from the 121st Psalms. I'll be reading 1 through 8. I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills, from which cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in from this time forth and even forevermore. May the Lord add a blessing to the hearers and doers of his holy word. I have read Psalms 121, verses 1 through 8. God bless each of you.
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory. Glory.
Thank you. Come on and lift him up, amen. Come on and praise God on today, amen. Hallelujah. Come on and lift him up on today, amen. He's worthy to be praised, amen. Hallelujah. From the rising of the sun to the setting of the same, amen. I don't know about you, but I'm glad I made it over to 2022, amen. And what shall we do in 2022, amen? What shall we do in 2022, amen? We should continue to trust in God, amen. We should continue to be faithful, amen. Come on and lift him up on today, amen. Hallelujah. Even in the midst of a pandemic, we can still praise him, amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let us look to the Lord in prayer, amen. Father God in heaven, we thank you, we glorify you for yet another day, oh God. We thank you, oh God, for another year, oh God, with new beginnings, amen. With you at the helm, oh God. With you at the steering the steering wheel, oh God. We thank you, oh God. As we go into our worship service on today, oh God, let us be reminded of the hills and valleys that we had in 2021, oh God. But also let us be reminded of how you brought us through, oh God. In Jesus Christ's name, oh God. As we look to the future, oh God, we know where our hope comes from, oh God. And it is in you, oh God. Oh God, we continue to look to you, oh God. The Alpha and Omega, oh God. The beginning and the end, oh God. The author and the finisher of our faith, oh God. Hallelujah. We don't know what 2022 is going to bring, oh God. But we know, oh God, that we will continue to trust in you, oh God. In Jesus Christ's name, oh God. We can't see it, oh God, but we believe by faith, oh God, that you will continue to lead and guide us, oh God. In Jesus Christ's name, oh God. And oh God, we're praying for our pastor, oh God, that you will continue to bless him, oh God. Continue to strengthen him, oh God. Oh God, continue to minister unto him, oh God. In Jesus Christ's name, oh God. Bless his family, oh God. Continue to keep a hedge of protection around them, oh God. Oh God, let them continue to share the love of Jesus with others, oh God. In Jesus Christ's name. And oh God, we're praying for our membership on today, oh God, that you will continue to bless each and every one, oh God. Oh God, we're praying, oh God, that you bless everyone, oh God. Oh God, even those that couldn't make it out on today, oh God, in Jesus Christ's name, oh God, we thank you, we glorify you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
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 Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, oh God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Was it for your love? Was it for your grace? I don't know where I'd be without you. If it wasn't for your love, was it for your grace? I don't know where I'd be without you.
He's been good to us, hasn't he? He brought us safely through the year 2021 into the year 2022. He's an awesome God. And you know what? We're expecting great things for him in the year 22. Let's give him the hand clap of praises for bringing us over to a new year. Amen. Now, this time has been set aside to recognize our visitors. If you're visiting here today, we welcome you to St. Paul once again into the new year. Amen. A new start to a new year. Amen. Our purpose here is to edify, educate, and empower the people of God with the word of God. And we are so grateful for those who press your way today to make this program what it is. And for those in Facebook and YouTube, we welcome you once again. God bless you and God keep you. It certainly
our prayer.
Amen. Let's give him the hand clap of praise. Amen and amen.
Prayer time. Amen. Amen. You look throughout the Bible. Amen. Prayer was such an important time in the lives of God's people. Amen. I read this morning in my daily reading that I think it's Genesis chapter 4 when he first began to call on the name of the Lord. Amen. And as we look to the Lord in prayer today, I want you all to keep that in mind as we seek the Lord. Amen. While he may be found, and call upon him while he is near. On our prayer list, we have Pastor John T. Banks, Brother James Barnett Sr., Brother Kenneth Alexander, Brother Jerome Blackman, Brother Teddy Blackman Jr., Brother Aaron Booker, Deacon Cleotha Caesar, Brother John Dixon, Brother Aaron Freeman, Brother Lazarus Freeman, Brother Odell Graham and family, Brother Keith Green, Brother George Herman, Deacon Ronnie Knight, Brother James Lanier, Brother Salvanus Lanier, Brother Robert Mitchell, Brother C.Z. Moffitt, Brother Junior Ray, Brother Michael Ross, Brother John Sullivan is here with us today. Brother Melvin Walker, Brother Ken Walker, Reverend Lonnie Williams, Brother Michael Wilson, Brother Elmer Wright, I'd like to add Deacon Roger Jones. Also, we have the entire St. Paul Missionary Baptist Church family, amen. Sister Eunice Banks and family, Sister Valerie Brooks, Sister Azalee Cartwright, Sister Vivian Clayton, Sister Mandy Craig, Sister Verlene Craig, Sister Roberta Fisto, Sister Felicia Hager and family, Sister Barbara Hood and family, Sister Lelar Jackson, Sister Clara Jenkins, Sister Sylvanus Johnson and family, Sister Julia Jones, Sister Sharon Jones, Sister Rosie Lanier, Sister Estella Maxwell, Sister Cynthia McDaniels, Sister Stephanie Moffitt, Sister Lynette Parker, Sister Carrie Perry, Sister Mary Rambo, Sister Jada and Destiny Shackelford, Sister Billy Simmons, Sister Vera Suber, Sister Cynthia Summerlin, Sister Naversha Summerlin, Sister Carrie Unger, Sister Avery Valentine, Sister Chelsea Wolford, Sister Betty Williams, Sister Darcelle Williams, Sister Linda Williams, and Sister Clara Yarbrough. And in bereavement, we have the Williams family, the Abbott family, the family of Sister Tracy Boatwright, and the family of Sister Queen Dickerson. Saints, can we just look to the Lord in prayer? Jesus would teach his disciples in the 6th chapter of Matthew a preferred pattern of prayer. And he said, when you pray, pray after this manner. And he gives us literally an outline to pray. Amen. How many of you know that prayer needs to be taught? Amen. For in Luke chapter 11, his disciples came to him and said, teach us how to pray. As John taught his disciples. And as we pray, let us keep those people lifted in our prayers. Father, in Jesus' name, Father, we thank you for this day, for you already said in your word that this is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. Father, I thank you for even the unspeakable joy in which you've given us in knowing that you are our joy and that the joy of the Lord is our strength. Father, I thank you for allowing us to be here in this house of worship today, Father. For you've seen us on the highways and the byways, and you made a way for us to be here today. Father, I thank you for showing us a more excellent way. Yeah. and that's through your only begotten Son and our Savior, Jesus the Christ. Father, we thank you for the many blessings in which you bestowed upon us, Lord God, things in which we have yet to even see. Father, we thank you for even the unspeakable miracles, Lord God, that you have performed in our lives, things that have yet to be even medically noted, Lord God, even for the healing virtue that you have released, Lord God, through the power of your word.
Yes.
Father, we realize that you are Jehovah Rapha, Lord God, the Lord that healeth thee.
Yes.
And Father, we believe that you are God, and besides you, there is no other. Father, we thank you for our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ, who you have given all power in heaven and earth. And we thank you for allowing us to call on his holy name. As we cry out to you today, Father, as we invoke your very name and hallow your name and sanctify your name in this place, we're reminded by your word that wherever your word is recorded, that you will show up and bless us. Father, we know you are Jehovah Shammah, the Lord our peace. And we're praying, Heavenly Father, that your peace that surpasses all understanding will continually guard our hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Father, we thank you for your people here today, Lord God, that have pressed their way today, even through the snow, Lord God. I pray that you will reward their faithfulness, Lord God. I pray that you will continue to allow them to receive the reward of those that diligently seek him. And Father, for those that could not come out today, Lord God, I pray that you would even place your spirit upon them right where they are, Lord God, whether they are watching by way of Facebook or YouTube. Father, we know that you are an ever-present God. Father, we're praying that you would manifest your presence to them, oh God, and that you would meet every need, Lord God. Father God, for that person that's trying to make ends meet, Lord God, show him that you are Jehovah Rohi, Lord God, the Lord our shepherd. And as your servant David said, that you are our shepherd and we shall not want, Lord God. Father God, thank you for supplying and meeting every need, Lord God. Father, you see even the physical lack that's taking place in the land, Lord God. Whether it be in terms of sickness or infirmity or affliction, Lord God, we know that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. Father, we understand that you have all power in your Son. And we ask you today to touch your people in a mighty way. Father, as we learn in our word today in our Sunday school lesson, that you are the way, the truth, and the light, Lord Jesus. And we thank you for showing us a way out of darkness, for calling us out of darkness and into your marvelous light. We thank you for the truth in which you've given us and given us an opportunity to know the truth. For you said in your word, and knowing the truth, and the truth shall set us free.
Yeah.
I pray today that your presence will be felt by your people and that your indwelling spirit will fill us, Lord God. Let our cups run it over. Anoint us afresh and anew. As I pray for our pastor today, Lord God, I pray that you would prop him up on both sides, Lord God. Father God, help him to continue to carry your word, Father God, to this lost and dying generation, to this perverse world, Lord God, in these perilous times. Father, I pray that you would speak to him and speak through him, oh God. Father God, bless those, oh Father God, that are in leadership positions, Father God, throughout the land. We know, as the deacon said earlier, that there has been some ups and downs, oh God, but I pray that you would put a press in their spirit, oh God, that they will continue to seek you and to serve you. Father God, we're praying for those that are in the White House, Lord God, that are making decisions, Lord God, regarding the people's life that are a part of these United States. I pray for our city officials, Lord God. I pray for even the students as well as the teachers that will be going back to school, Lord God. And I just pray that you will receive the glory and the honor and the praise. For it's in Jesus' name we pray. Thank God and amen. God bless you.
Thank you, Reverend Warfield. Amen for that powerful prayer. Two things we know. Prayer works and Jesus will never fail you. I feel like going on. I feel like going on. Though trials come on, like pressing my way, because God has been good. I feel like pressing my way. I feel like pressing my way. Though trials come on every hand, I feel like pressing my way. Let us pray. Father, we thank you, we praise you, we glorify you. We thank you for the gifts that we've just received. Our prayer, dear Lord, is that you bless the gift and then bless the giver. And then we pray that this offering will be used for the purpose that it is raised, to lift up your kingdom here on earth. Our final request is that as you take it from our hands, that you use it to bring glory to your kingdom. And then we ask these blessings. In Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah and amen. 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 Well, we understand that the weather's kind of bad outside. But God is still moving on the inside.
Amen.
Amen. And we're so grateful for you, to you for pressing your way today. Amen, amen, amen. God is good.
Amen.
And he's worthy to be praised. Amen. Let's just praise him again. Millions didn't make it. But we have something to praise God for, because we are some of the ones that did. Amen. I don't know about you, but I'm looking for great things to take place in 2022. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Well, turn with me, if you would, to the book of Ephesians, chapter 4, verses 22 through 24. Amen. Ephesians chapter 4, verses 22 through 24. Amen, amen, amen. Has God been good to you?
Amen.
Amen. New year with new desires. Amen. And my desire is to please him in the things that I do and the things that I say.
Amen.
Amen. These words are recorded. And it says that he put off concern in the former conversation, the old man, which is corrupt according to the deceitful lust, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind, and that ye put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. Amen. This is the word of God, and it's for the people of God. Amen. I want to talk to you for just a few minutes from the subject, the new man in Christ. Amen. The new man in Christ. And you know, if I had to have a subtopic, my subtopic would be new in 2022. Amen. New in 2022. And you know, as I looked at these scriptures, it took me all the way back to my childhood. And you know, when we were born, we were given a name by our parents, and we wear those names proudly. Amen. A long time ago, they named the young boy Benny. And Benny has worn that name proud. I see a lot of people sometimes want to change their names, but I love that name that they gave me, Benny. Sometimes we're named after fathers, and they call us Junior. Sometimes we're named after our mothers, grandfathers, grandmothers. Amen. We were even named after some of our favorite uncles and some of our favorite aunts. Amen. But we still wear those names proudly. Amen. And you know what? These birth-given names became a part of us, and we wear these names proudly. And you know what? We wear these names until death do us part. And I like the way Proverbs 22 and 1, because it says that a good name means a good reputation. And did you know that a good name is worth more than cash money? Amen. If you got the right name, you can go down there and buy a car now by just signing your name. A good name and a good reputation. And you know, that reminded me when I was young and we would go to the basketball games and our parents would let us go. But then they would also warn us to stay out of trouble. In other words, I want you to bring home a good reputation. Amen. Amen. And we should always try to maintain a good reputation. Amen. We were taught the importance of having a good reputation. Even in the early days of our youth, if we did something or we said something that was out of character, we had to answer to our parents. In other words, if somebody told them that we had said something out of character, that we had done something out of character, we had to suffer some consequences. Amen. Amen. In other words, we knew that there would be some consequences if we messed up. Amen. And I remember one time I had an old friend named Ralph Cobbage, and he wasn't really the best company to keep. And I messed around in Ralph Cobbage's presence, and Ralph Cobbage did something he shouldn't have done. And I was afraid it was going to mess up my good reputation. And I tell you, I had to pray about that situation. But I thank God that he is good, because he has gotten me out of so many bad situations. And I'm still able to maintain a good reputation.
Thank you, Lord.
In other words, you ought to let your yeses be yes and your noes be no. Amen. Paul said, when we are born again, we're given a new name. Did y'all know once we accepted Christ as our Lord and Savior, that we were given a new name? Now that we are Christians, now that we are Christ-like, or we are like Christ, do you know what that means? That means that we are representatives of the kingdom of God. So in other words, as Christians, we represent the kingdom of God. Paul is telling the Ephesian church that when we have been changed from the old man
to the new man in Christ. We who have been saved no longer live as we used to, or say the things that we used to say. In other words, there's a change that has taken place on the inside, because we are representatives of the kingdom of God.
Amen.
Amen. And you know, three things that Paul is pointing out in our text today about the new man. And the first thing he points out about the new man is that once you are a new man or a new woman, you should have a new conversation. Amen. The second thing you should have is a new conduct. Amen. And the third thing is you are a new creation. A new conversation. You know what that means, don't you? The things that you used to say, you don't say those things anymore.
Amen.
Well, let's look at the new conversation, or the conversation of the new man. It is said that the mouth and the heart are connected, because what you think in your heart will come out in your mouth. In other words, if you are thinking in some kind of way, you're going to show some kind of emotion. Amen. Amen. And you know what? The mouth shouldn't always say what the heart thinks.
Amen.
Because sometimes your mouth can get you in a whole lot of trouble.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. That is why we should fill our hearts with the love of Christ. Can I tell you this? A bitter attitude can poison the inner man and cause him to have a bad attitude. Have you ever seen people that always got a bad attitude? They seem like they are always mad at the world, that nothing is ever good. Everything is always bad. Amen. There's nothing worse than a Christian with a bad attitude.
Amen.
Ain't that right, y'all?
Amen.
Because we are supposed to be representatives of Christ.
Yes, God.
Amen. How are you representing Christ? Well, in Colossians 4:6, Paul said, let your conversation always be full of grace and seasoned with some salt. Amen. Amen. And then you will know how to give a graceful answer to each other and how to talk to each other. But you know, it's a lot of people that don't know how to talk to you.
Amen.
Amen. You can be feeling good and have a conversation with people, and they'll just mess up your day by that conversation. You could be feeling good, and all of a sudden, they will just vex your spirit and make you hate you ever said anything to them. And sometimes you could just be speaking to them, good morning, and you know what they'll say to you? What's good about it? Well, if you're here to experience it, I think that's good enough within itself. Amen. As a new man, we are to be good examples of our conversation. Amen. We should be courteous. Ain't that right, y'all? Don't try to out-talk nobody. Don't always try to get people to see it our way. And sometimes when they say things we don't like, we need to just humble ourselves. Well, a lot of times, I had to bite my tongue trying to be humble, because I figured if I made a statement, I would only make them mad, and I wasn't gonna argue about it. Amen. Need to be Christ-like, or just like Christ.
Amen.
And you know what? The new man ought to be tender-hearted. When you see something you need to react to, Don't just tell a person I'm praying for you, but try to do something about it. Amen. And a lot of times, people think that you're weak, but you're not being weak. You're just being weak, meek. You're just being meek. Because the meek will inherit the earth. Amen. We need to be just like Christ. Amen. Amen. For the scripture says, let this mind be in you that was also in Christ Jesus. Our words have power. So let our conversation always have grace, seasoned with salt. And you know when you put a little salt on it, make it taste better, don't it? Amen. Our conversation should be free from gossip. Amen. Always talking about people. Amen. Seeing the wrong thing about a person without seeing anything good. Because there's some good in the worst of us. Isn't it, y'all? Amen. Not always talking about each other. Regardless of whatever a person has done, I can do it better. Well, maybe you can do it better. But give him a chance to make his mistakes and learn from his mistakes. Because we have seasoned our conversation with salt. Paul was telling them that the new man should always put some salt of grace in everything that he said. And you know, when I read this, I thought about the fact that, you know, sometimes before we speak, it would be good to just whisper a little prayer to the Lord.
Amen.
Before you speak. Sometimes we know if we have a conversation with certain people that they're going to make you mad. So it'd be a good thing before you have a conversation with that person. Just talk to God first. Tell him about the situation. And I can assure you that he will make a difference. Amen. In Leviticus 2:13 of the Old Testament, the Jews used salt in their daily sacrifices because salt symbolized purity. They call salt grace because salt gave flavor to things. And when we talk, we ought to put a little salt in our conversation. And that will put some of God's flavor in our situation. In our lives, flavor gives us favor. And favor can only come from God. Let me give you an example. You remember the woman that was caught in adultery?
Oh, yes.
And Jesus said to her, neither do I condemn you. And what he showed her was grace. Amen. He knew she had done wrong. But he didn't try to tear her down because of what she had done.
Amen.
Many times we try to tear people down because of what they've done. Because we have struggles ourselves and we want mercy.
Oh, yeah.
Then Jesus said to that woman, but go and sin no more. And you know what he did? That was so. There are times we have to build up people.
Oh, yeah.
And forgive people rather than tear them down. Sometimes we have to encourage one another, because sometimes encouragement will go a long way.
Oh, yeah.
If we do it the right way. And you know, we have to be careful that we're not trying to bring people up to our level, because sometimes we make mistakes ourselves. Amen. Amen. So we need to have a good conversation. We need to have a good reputation. Amen. Job had a good reputation. because people came to Job to get their problems solved. And you ought to carry yourself in such a way that people don't mind coming to you and asking you for some godly advice. Amen. We've talked about the conversation. Now let us talk about the conduct. Y'all know what the conduct is, don't you? The way you act. So Paul is telling them about the conduct of the new man in Christ. The way a believer should act. What Paul is telling them to watch the way that you act. And the way a Christian is to talk and walk must be in harmony. Let me see if I can make it a little bit clearer. Don't say one thing and then do another. Don't say, amen, don't do as I do, but do as I say. Isn't that bad? You're going to tell people don't do as you do, but do as you say. And you'll try to be an example. That is not harmony in Christ. Amen. Can I point this out? Remember when we were in school and on our report card, it had deportment? Y'all know what deportment was? Deportment was the way you act in school. And can I share this with you? If I came home and I had an F in deportment, I had to answer to my parents. And let me tell you the results, it was not good. Amen. I remember one time, called myself on the bus, I was attending to my own business. And this old boy just kept on messing with me. Amen. I came to the limit. Amen. Couldn't take no more from that boy. Just bullying me, you know. And you know how it is with bullies. They just seem to get worse if you try to be mean. You ever had anybody like that? The nicer you try to be to them, the worse they act, because they were bullies. And one evening, on my way home, I was sitting there and that boy just pushed me to the limits. And I got up and I hit him one good time. Amen. Amen. I had to pay the price for it when I got home, because my parents had told me don't be fighting. Amen. God help me. Amen. The whooping wasn't so good. I'm so glad I won that fight. Amen. So deportment told our parents how we conducted ourselves in school. If our conduct was bad, we had to suffer some consequences for bad conduct. But if our conduct was good, you know what happened? We were rewarded and we were praised for having a good conduct. Our parents showed us that they trusted in us and they could trust us if we had a good conduct. The gospel teaches us how to be saved, but the epistles teaches us how to behave. And just like it is important for a Christian to be saved, it is also important for a Christian to know how to behave. Amen. On this Christian journey, amen, our report card, we're going to have to give an account for bad conduct. In other words, if we act out of character, we're going to have to give an account one day for our bad conduct. Well, look at Noah's report card. Because Noah had a close relationship with God. You see, we can only have a good report card when our relationship with God is good. Let me tell you about Noah, because he walked upright because Noah found favor with the Lord. Because the Bible says that he was a just man. He always tried to do what was right. He always tried to say the right things. Noah was in right standing with God. And I want to ask the question today, how are you standing with God? And the other question, is your report card good? Well, the scripture tells us that the new man should know how to walk. And then the scripture tells us that he should know how to walk not. Amen. Amen. It says you should walk not after the flesh. In other words, don't let your flesh be in control of you. Walk not like the manner of other men. Don't do it because other people are doing it. That don't mean it's right because everybody else is doing it. Don't break into the White House because everybody else is breaking into the White House. In other words, walk not in the manner of men. Then it says, walk not by sight. In other words, sometimes what you see is not really the true story of what is going on. So we are to walk not by sight. Amen. But the new man should walk after the Spirit. Let the Spirit of God lead you in everything you say and everything you do. Walk by faith. Put your faith in God and keep on moving. Walk in honesty. Let your yes be yes and your no be no. And then walk in good works. Amen. Always try to do good. Amen. Even if people put you down, don't pay evil for evil, but do some good works. Amen. Amen. My mama told us when we were growing up, and I didn't understand it then, but she said that kindness will kill a mule. I didn't understand what she meant. Well, she was trying to tell us that if somebody do something evil to you, if you want to get them back, just do something good for them. Amen. Amen. And then walk according to the word of God. Amen. Glorify God and not yourself. Whatever you do, do it to the glory of God and not for yourself. In other words, don't do it to make yourself look big, but do it for the glory of God. Amen. And I like this because it says that if we walk right, we can witness right. Amen. Amen. And we can at least save our own families just like Noah did. Because you know what? It's all about salvation. And look what Noah went through. God spoke to him and told him to build an ark because it was going to rain. Do you know that Noah was talked about, made fun of? Sometimes when God gives you an assignment, people are going to talk about you. They're going to say all manner of things about you. But if God said it, go ahead and do it and glorify God, which is in heaven. Because if God gives you the instructions, he will see you through. Didn't he see Noah through? Because when it began to rain, Noah called his family in to the ark. And when it began to rain, you know what Noah did? He locked himself inside of the ark. And when it began to rain, can't you see him and his family now rising up above the talk that they did about it? He rose up for being talked about and lied on, because when God told him to do it, he did it, and he rose above it all. Amen. When you obey God's instructions, you can rise above it all. Well, the third thing that Paul pointed out about the new creation, when you accept Christ as your Lord and Savior, you are a new creation. You pulled off the old man and you put on the new man. Amen. We have been created in the image of Christ. And isn't it good to know that we are in the image of the Savior? We are to walk and we are to talk just like Christ. 2 Corinthians 5:17, Paul said, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. That the old things are passed away, and behold, all things are become new, because you are a new man. And the evidence of the new man in Christ is found in our conversation and in our conduct, because the things we used to say, we don't say those things anymore. The places that we used to go and even invite other people to go, we don't have a desire to go to those places anymore, because we are a new man in Christ. Amen. A new man in Christ must realize that he had a new covenant made by grace and the blood of Jesus, his son. We also have a new covenant, amen, to love one another. And I'm so glad we are clothed in a new robe, the robe of righteousness. We also have a new promise, the promise that Jesus will never leave us, nor will he forsake us. Amen. Full of promises. And the promise was fulfilled when Jesus went to Calvary, because we are a new man in Christ. Amen. And I'm finished now. But let me finish with the story of a man who was considered to be the worst of men. Amen. Nobody wanted to be around this man. He had the label of a robber and a thief. And you know how it is. Nobody wants to be around a robber and a thief, because he will stick you up. And when you're gone, he'll take your little stuff from you. A robber and a thief. Well, one day, this man, this robber and the thief, he met a man by the name of Jesus. He gave his heart to the master. In other words, what I'm trying to tell you today, that this old robber, this old thief was changed when he met the master. Amen. But this is the admiring thing about this old robber and this old thief.
guess what he did? Something that he had never done before. This old robber and this old thief, he went out and got him a job. Ain't that good? He used to get up in the morning looking for something to steal. Get up in the morning looking for somebody to rob. Amen. But when he met Jesus, his whole life changed. Amen. He had a desire to get a job. And he got himself a job. Amen. God will change you if you want to be changed. Yeah. Let me tell you the end of the story. Because this old robber got a job. He worked from sun up to sundown. Amen. On the job. And can't you see him now going to work for the first time with a smile on his face, with joy in his heart? Yeah. Working from sun up to sundown. Ain't that all right? But that's not the end of the story. Because I know that you're wondering, what is he going to do with that money? Well, I'm glad you asked. Let me tell you, when the change took place, you know what he did? He made up in his mind that everybody that he had robbed, everybody that he had stolen from, he wanted to take the money that he made and pay them back. Ain't God all right? You see, when the Lord comes into your life, you are a changed person. Amen. When he comes into your life, he changed your conversation. Instead of saying, stick up, he's told him, bless you now. Ain't God all right? He changed his conduct. Instead of taking from man, he was giving back what he had taken. And you know why? Because he was a new creation in God. When God comes into your life, he changes you. But there's some changes that you have to make. You have to change your conversation. You have to change your conduct. And sometimes you wonder why. But the reason is, you are a new creation. And you are created in the image of God. Amen. He was always giving. Amen. He was even willing to give his life that we might be free to the tree of life. Amen. And the evidence is Calvary, where he was willing to die for your sin and mine. It was at Calvary that he died. But I'm so glad he didn't stay dead, because we're going to be celebrating in a few minutes the risen Savior. He rose. Didn't he rise, y'all? He rose on that third day with all power in heaven and in earth in his hand, with power to change our conversation, power to change our conduct, because we are a new creation in Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. God bless you and God keep you. The doors of the church is now open. If you're here today and you have not accepted Christ as your Lord and Savior, we'd like to extend to you an invitation right now to come by letter Christian Experience or a candidate for baptism. Is there one today? I will trust in the Lord. I will trust in the Lord. I will trust in the Lord until I die. Till I die, I will trust in the Lord. I will trust in the Lord. I will trust in the Lord.
till I die. Is that one today? You ought to make 2022 an unforgettable year. Because it could be the year that you gave your life to Christ. The year that he changed you. You know what? He's standing there with arms wide open, ready to welcome you home. Because one of these old days, we're going to have to give up the ghost. And we need to know that there's a place built by the hands of man. Job said, well, the wicked ceases from trouble, and the weary will be at rest. He told us this morning about a mansion that he was preparing for us. And he said, if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself. That where I am, you will be also. And isn't it good to know that we got another home better than this old place we're living in down here? Because down here, if it ain't one thing, it's another. Seem like down here is just trouble after trouble. But we have a new home prepared by the Master. Just for us. Say a word. I will trust in the Lord. Thank you. We thank God for you.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Today we don't have any virtual announcements. Amen. But you know what? This is community.
Amen.
And I thank God that he has allowed us to come together one more time.
Yes, God.
Amen. The first communion of the year.
Amen.
You know, when I was young, they used to tell us if you start the year out right, you can end up right. And I'm so thankful for those who pressed their way out here today, because you started this year outright. You put God first, because the scripture tells us in all thy ways, acknowledge him. And he will do what? Direct your path. So we've come today to get our directions. Has everybody been served? Those of you watching by Facebook or YouTube, you have an opportunity to commune with us today. If you have your wine, some crackers, you can still join us in communion today. I know it was blood. I know it was a blood. I know it was a blood for me. One day when I was lost, he died upon the cross. And I know it was a blood for me. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for this opportunity to come again and to commune together. For you said in your word, this do in remembrance of me. For as often as we eat this bread and drink this wine, we do show forth the Lord's death until he comes. And we know one day you're coming back again, because you said you were coming back for church without a spot or wrinkle. And Lord, we just want to be ready when you come. Amen. Thank you. We praise you. We glorify you. In Jesus' name, amen. Scripture says that after he had called his disciples together, after he had given thanks, that he and his disciples ate and they drank together. Let us do the same. Let us eat
because this bread represents the blood of Christ. Now let us pray. Because this wine represents the blood that he shed on Calvary. I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood for me. One day when I was lost, he died upon the cross. And I know it was the blood for me. It was my Savior's blood. I know the Savior's blood. It was my Savior's blood. It was my Savior's blood for me. One day when I was lost, he died on the cross. And I know it was the blood.
God bless you. God keep you. Amen. Thank you so much, musicians and Reverend Warfield. We know that a lot of our members are sick. We want to keep them lifted up in prayer because we know there are a lot of them that would have been here today if it had not been for the sickness. So we bind that sickness right now in the name of Jesus, because the scripture tells us whatever we bound here on earth will be bound in heaven. And then we pray to God when loose here, his healing and his joy in the name of Jesus. Whatever is loosed in heaven, loosed on earth. And we're going to claim the victory right now by faith in the name of Jesus. God bless you and God keep you. And I pray that you get a double portion of his goodness and his mercy to lead you through this new year. Amen. Scripture said they, after they sang a hymn, Jesus came.